Chocolate contains a number of compounds associated with mood-lifting effects. World-renowned chocolatier Dominique Persoon from the Chocolate Line is well aware of this. He and his son Julius have been working with Dr. Thomas Moores, director at Shout at Cancer, to let people suffering from throat cancer enjoy tasteful food again by creating personalized one-of-a-kind chocolates.
Hi Thomas. Hi Julius. Hi Thomas, you contacted the Chocolate Line and a food pairing a few months ago with a challenge. Can you tell us what that challenge was, and can you also introduce yourself?
I'm Dr. Thomas Moores, director of Shout at Cancer, a charity that helps to improve speech and finding balance in life again after losing your voice box. In the worst cases of throat cancer, surgeons have to take away the entire voice box to make people better. This is called a laryngectomy. The windpipe is brought forward into the neck, and that is where these people breathe in and out from. They lose their voice, but also their smell, as they no longer breathe through their nose. This also affects their taste. The operation complicates swallowing afterwards as well. The swallow is even more complicated with side effects caused by radiotherapy. This changes the taste, and a long-standing dry mouth can be caused by it. And we want to improve the quality of life for a target group and explain this layered impact after laryngectomy in a positive and attractive way to a broader audience. To help them with their speech, we use singing, acting, and beatboxing. And to explain it to the audience, we use a choir. Do this during our concerts. So we were wondering, how can we explain that it's not just the loss of the voice box? And what could we do for our group to help them and to offer them a treat to eat? So when I heard that they even struggle eating chocolates, I knew that's it. I approached the Chocolate Line and asked them, as Belgians, we cannot just stand idle when there are people who cannot enjoy chocolates as much as before. And they straight away replied, count us in.
So this is removed, and then they get a connection. So because of that, because this part is removed, the smell is gone, and the voice is gone. So he's directing a choir, so the people learn again to use their voice. But the challenge he had was really, okay, I also want those people to be capable to enjoy food. And as he also is a Belgian, he really wants also people to enjoy chocolate. So the challenge was, could he also make a chocolate for these people? So how did we go? So the flavor ID, you have seen it in the meantime a few times. So with the group of people, we collected the flavor ID before the treatment and after the treatment, because we really want to understand how their flavor preferences was changing over time. So by filling in this flavor ID, our algorithms could extract what the people liked before and what they still like after the treatment. So what did we find out? Well, if you look at the texture, so the dark green is before and the light green is after. So while before people liked to chew or crunchy textures, after the treatment it really switched toward more softer and more juicier textures. And the reason why is that because of the operation, they don't make so much of a saliva, and their mouth becomes really, really, really dry. So in taste, what we found out is that the liking for a lot of products is reduced, but especially for bitter products. So if something is bitter, they don't like it as much after the treatment as before. If you then look into the flavor ID and try to extract what they still like after the treatment, what we actually found out was that products like berries, so for example, you see here, again, before treatment, dark green, lighter green after the treatment. So you see that actually the liking before and after more or less is still the same, and the liking is quite high. The same for mint. meant we also see the same, so the liking is more or less the same, maybe even a bit more after the treatment. So an ideal chocolate for those people would actually be a chocolate that is not too bitter, more sour, that has some juiciness, so because they don't make that much of a saliva, and that would contain some more strawberry and some minty notes. So that was the information that I passed on to Julius, and where he started to make a chocolate.
So we made a new type of chocolate for this bonbon, and during the fermentation process, we have added acids of sourdough bread. We work together with Belcolada, so it gives more acidity when you bite in it. More acidity means more saliva.
Yeah.
Then the first layer of the chocolate is like a strawberry minty gel that we put into the vacuum machine. And when you put it in the vacuum machine, it intensifies the color and the structure of the gel to turn it more into like a lotion, so it's easier to eat.
Yeah.
The second layer is a layer of artificial saliva. It's like a jelly we made, and it's very funny. When you heat it up the first time, the artificial saliva jelly, it turns into like a snot. So it's really important when you make jellification with it, that you first add agar citras, heat it up, and afterwards, when you mix it in the Thermomix, you add the artificial saliva. So when you bite in it, it really runs into your mouth, so it's really, really funny product, really nice to try.
Yeah. And when you hear about artificial saliva, it sounds like a bit gross, but what is it?
Well, it's like some type of salt protein, and it gives like an exact replica of saliva, so it's really interesting as well. It's really cool product.
Yeah, it's a combination of water and salt and the sugar, actually.
Indeed.
What you have in your mouth.
But it's really difficult to combine chocolate and water.
Yeah.
So it's important that you first spray a small layer of tempered cocoa butter inside your mold. Afterwards, you add the jelly of the artificial saliva and you spray it again. So it's like a protection layer, a type of film. When you bite in it, it's the first layer that will be exposed into your mouth.
Okay.
The idea was as well to design the chocolate into a pill form. So it's like to improve life. So we wanted to make it more look like a medicine. Bitter pills shouldn't be always difficult to eat, and bitter and also pleasant to eat. That was the idea behind it.
Yeah. And I think we also have some testimonials of people that actually tasted the chocolates.
So I've just got in from work. Some post chocolates waiting for me. Let's see what they like.
Here goes. Very, very liquid. Very easy to eat. Delicious. Really, really lovely. Nothing getting stuck on the roof of my mouth at all. And very easy to swallow. And really gives the taste buds going. Chocolate data's sort of coming through now as well.
Right. Oh man, that's really good.
I don't feel normally like dark chocolate, but with that strawberry, it's very, very nice.
It's a little bit runny, that was the only thing I would say. Needed to be a bit more firm.
I'm very fussy about chocolate.
Very enjoyable, obviously. It's a type of chocolate I can actually eat. Thank you.
Very nice. Very nice.
Very easy to eat.
I love that. Good work. I'll have some more then, thank you.
So apparently the people are really enthusiastic. So
they're very happy to hear that.
Great job. So what's going to happen next with the chocolates?
Well, we're going to do some tests, because now with water, it's very difficult to make a product that has a long shelf life, because it's really important for us as well. We want to have a product which is at least 3 weeks of a shelf life. So instead of making like a jellification now with only water to recreate saliva, we wanted to add it to maybe other types of shells of citrus to maybe have like the same power, but to add it to a different type of product that you can keep longer, to have a longer shelf life. So that's the new thing we're Yeah, we're testing about right
can
now.
Can I actually have a bite because I still
absolutely
didn't taste
yeah, sure.
The chocolate yet.
It's quite runny, so be careful.
Yeah, indeed, it's really runny. It's really nice. Good job.
Thank you very much.